In this part and the next part, we will explain the method of the working and implementation of the project in the ArcSWAT program. Whereas after we grouped and prepared the shapefile maps of land cover and soil type for one country, which is Iraq, or for two or more countries, namely Iraq and Syria, from the raster and shapefile maps of the world as shown in the previous parts of the series of videos of the soil type and land use category, where we will here use the shapefile maps of land cover and soil type in implementing the ArcSWAT program for a study area as follows. First, we go to the desktop and we create a new project file entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1. And inside this file, SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1, we put the weather data for the study area here, taken from the global weather data for SWAT website, which is inside this file entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur. And this file contains weather data for the study area, where we make for it copy and transfer it to the project file entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1 via paste. And inside it, we create a file entitled SWAT project. We also add to the project file here entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1 the dam map of the study area, which is located inside the file entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur. And this map is titled Wadi Al Mur .dam, where we make for it copy and transfer it inside the project file entitled SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1 through paste. Now we go to the ArcMap program, and in it we find the ArcSWAT menu bar, the number of which is 6 menu. One, two, three, four, five, six. To implement the project in ArcSWAT, we go to the first menu entitled SWAT Project Setup, and we open this menu and we choose a new SWAT project. Then we press no. A window called the project setup appears, in which we go to the first field titled project directory and locate the project file in the following path. this top SWAT Wadi Al Mur 1 SWAT project. Then we press OK. The options are specified inside the rest of the field, and then we press OK. A message appears showing SWAT setup is done, then we press OK. Then we go to the second menu from the ArcSWAT menu bar, which is titled Watershed Delineator, and in it we choose Automatic Watershed Delineation. A window entitled Watershed Delineation appears, in which we go to the DEM setup and open the DEM map for the study or project area, where we click on Open File, and then we choose Load from Disk, then OK. Then we go to the project file path on the desktop titled SWAT Wadi Al-Mur 1 and select the map Wadi Al-Mur.dem. Then we click on Add. Immediately, if added, the map will be converted to raster. Then we go to the DEM projection setup and click on Property, and we note that the units in X and Y coordinates are in meters, while the unit of height Z is not specified, so we choose the unit in meters. Then we press OK. Then we go and click on Calculation, Flow, Direction and Accumulation icon. A message appears that the operation was successful. Then we press OK. Then we go and click on icon creating stream and outlet. A message appears indicating that the operation was successful. Then we click on OK. Then the flow lines appears in the DEM map of the study area. Then we go to outlet and inlet definition, and we choose sub-basin outlet. And we go to edit manually. Edit manually, and we choose add point. Then we press OK. We locate the outlet on the flow lines of the study area basin. Then I press left click on the outlet site. Then we make right click on the same site, and we click on the stop editing. Then yes. Then we return to the watershed delineation window, in which it is also possible to specify inlet or draining watershed, as well as point source input. Where we go to edit manually and select add point. And select add point. Then I press OK. and locate the point source input by making a left click on the flow lines. Then we make right click on the same site and we press stop editing, then yes. Then we go back to the watershed delineation window and set the option to subbasin outlet. Then we go to wall watershed outlet and click on the select icon, then OK. Then we select the outlet for the study area basin with the mouse, then we press OK. Then we click on the delineating watershed icon. We wait for the process to complete. And a message appears indicating that the watershed delineation is done. Then we press OK. The boundary of the study area are shown on the DEM map as we see. Then we go back to the watershed delineation window and we go and we click on the calculate subbasin parameters icon. We wait for the process to complete. Then a message appears indicating that subbasin parameter calculation successfully done. Then we press OK. We wait for the process to complete. Then we return to the watershed delineation window where after we have implemented calculate subbasin parameter, the option add or delete receiver is activated through which we can add a receiver to the study area. To add a reservoir to study area, we click on add reservoir, then OK. Then we locate at the reservoir on the outlet site by making left click on it, then we make right click on the same site and click on stop editing, then yes. Now, after adding the DEM map for the study area and calculating flow direction and accumulation, defining inlet and outlet, delineating watershed, and adding the reservoir, we press exit. To view the topographic report for the study area which we specified a little while ago, we go to the second menu of the ArcSWAT menu bar, which is titled Watershed Delineator, and in it we choose Watershed Report, then we choose Topographic report, then OK. The topographic report appears and contains comprehensive information about the study area. As we see, then we save the project by clicking on the save icon and continue implementation in the next parts.